is that she is, Big Dog had me talk to an old friend from when I was a Jehovah's Witness. You know, he studied with me and shit. Older guy, like 70, 80 years old, you know, it's cool. And I already knew, man, this is gonna be fun. This is gonna be fun. A chance to get persecuted, you know, which doesn't gotta mean like some, I got stoned or anything, it's all the same, you know what I'm saying? Persecuted, not, you know, looked at like fucking a weirdo, crazy person and shit. No. I love my weird. I love it. You know, God made me weird as a motherfucker. I love that shit. So, but, you know, I got nothing but love for Brother Coffee, man. I got nothing but love for him, man. And he actually, like, out of all the Jehovah's Witnesses that, that I ran into, he's stuck around. He stuck in and listened for a long time. He stuck in and fucking heard the words that I was saying for the longest. You know, usually they're supposed to get the fuck on. They're supposed to, anybody talks like how I talk, just, you know, about, you know, the things that, you know, being a believer, they're supposed to get the fuck out of this way. He hung out for about 30, 40 minutes. It makes them sad. I know, I see it. Because it looks, sounds like a, you know, scary. It sounds fucked up. You know, the shit that I say sounds fucked up. Of course it sounds fucked up. You never heard it. It's not what you're used to. It's not, you know what I'm saying? Somebody says something that you haven't heard of, it's not in your belief system. Yeah, it's going to be crazy. Crazy as fuck. It's fucking nuts. You know, that's the first thing that popped in your head. Like, that's fucking nuts. There's motherfuckers that are afraid of heights and motherfuckers that are afraid of heights. And to a motherfucker that's not afraid of heights, what is he? That nigga's fucking crazy as a motherfucker. He's fucking nuts. Fuck that shit. Fuck that motherfucker. Off his rocker. You know, so. No, he's like, what'd he say? He's like, does it look like I'm buying in it? Does it look like I'm buying any of what you're saying? Like, nigga, I'm not selling it. I'm just obeying, you know. He put you in my path for me to fucking, and the shit that he's shown me isn't for me to fucking bottle it up. The shit that I've experienced with walking with God isn't for me to bottle up and keep to myself. It's for me to fucking, I'm supposed to testify, you know what I'm saying? Give him his glory. Testify. And whatever happens with it is what happens with it. I didn't fucking have any intention like this. I'm going to change this motherfucker's life, man. Watch this. I'm going to fucking school his ass. No. I'm just doing what I'm supposed to do. And what is it? And it does exactly what he says it's going to do. It's going to make a motherfucker persecuted. You know, like, you know, it's going to look bad. You know what I'm saying? You know, needless to say, it's going to look bad. It's going to look fucking, you know, motherfucker's going to look super tripped out. And, can make a motherfucker look stupid and crazy and shit. That's the way he made it. That's the way he created it. And most motherfuckers, you know, some motherfuckers, they ain't gonna fucking talk about it. They ain't gonna talk about it for the simple fact that it's gonna, you know, from what it makes you look like. You don't know who you're walking past. You're walking past motherfuckers that are, you'll be walking past motherfuckers that know magic and motherfuckers that got superpowers and all that shit, because they leveled up to that shit. But they ain't gonna talk about that shit. One, they're gonna keep that shit for themselves because they know that this is a game, so they think it's a game of that I'm supposed to, you know, that they're supposed to, you know, be winning shit, but it's just a game. It's just a game. It's not for us to keep to the treasures that he gives us and the gifts and shit that he gives us. It's supposed to keep for ourselves, man. It's not a, you know, not like that. And, you know, you keep asking me why, but why is this, but why is that? Like, you keep asking why, but you keep saying about the Bible, but I told you, like, it says in there, and you just want to skip past that, you know, keep, you know, like I didn't, like it's not even in the Bible that don't lean on your own understanding and don't follow the teachings of man, which is telling you, don't fucking fuck your ego, fuck who you think you are and all the information that you have, and believe. Believe. And obviously, if the Bible says believe all those fucking times and niggas telling niggas to believe, he's telling you to believe some shit that's unbelievable. Believe shit that's unbelievable, not just believe in the shit that you understand and that you've learned from it. Shit's super draining, though. Fucking drained the fuck out of me. Drained my motherfucking battery. And it's crazy, too, because, like, all the shit that comes out of my mouth is, like, I could hear it. I could hear it. It just sounds like scattered gibberish, man. But motherfuckers that know, you know what I'm saying? Motherfuckers that know, they understand. They understand what I'm saying. They can understand. They understand the language, you know, that I'm speaking. But to fucking other motherfuckers, they don't, you know, it's just, I know it sounds like gibberish, man. Shit, I was deaf, dumb, and blind for 37 years, and I could imagine somebody saying the shit that I'm saying to him, and I'd be like, man, what the fuck are you talking about, man? I'm out. This nigga's on one. This nigga's on one, and he ain't even on one. Best believe, I'm on one. I'm on one. I'm always on one. No, he told me, you know what I'm saying? I love, if anything, if I ever want anything spiritual, to give him a call. You know? No, basically, fucking, basically, I gotta cut you off, you know what I'm saying? Until you want to fucking come be a Jehovah's Witness. You have to cut me off. That's not unconditional love, buddy. I love the shit out of you. But they don't understand. They don't see that. They don't see it. You know? And he says, unconditional love. Yeah, he's like, God is unconditional. But he says, don't, you know, about adultery and murder and all that shit. Those are conditions. I was like, well, which one do? Why do you want to believe that one, when instead of believing that he's unconditional love? Why do you want to fucking put conditions on this shit? You know what I'm saying? Why do you want to put conditions on this shit? Because something that you read that and you interpreted it a certain way, why do you want to interpret it that way? You know what I'm saying? There's many interpretations of this shit, and every single being is going to interpret everything different. Just depends which level of understanding they're at. No. I knew that was good. There wasn't nothing, there wasn't going to be some big fucking thing or any fucking thing about it. I just knew it was a fucking, well, it's another fucking, to see if I'm going to fucking, if I'm going to man up and make myself look like a fucking bonkers clown in front of somebody that I know, you know what I'm saying? Am I going to do that? Am I going to do that for God? Am I going to do that shit? Am I going to give him his glory, or am I going to tuck my tail and fucking, and fake it, you know what I'm saying? Like, am I going to tuck my tail and not give him his glory, you know? Like, fucking not do what I'm supposed to do. I ain't talking nothing. Not never. Balls deep. Balls deep in the game. I'm balls deep in this game. Nothing. Definitely a different effect to having to do that. You know, definitely different effects in my body and my inside body, my spiritual body. I can feel it from when I'm talking to somebody that is that understands. It's like, I'm talking about this shit, man. You're supposed to be talking about this shit. No. I believe I am supposed to be talking about this shit. I am supposed to be talking about this shit. It ain't for us to fucking keep or to give to whoever we want. You know, the motherfuckers that we want to give it to, you know what I'm saying? Give it to my home. I'm giving gang to my homies. You know, to prove, to pop. No, it ain't about that. You know, at least it ain't about that for me. You know, that ain't how he taught me, man. But it ain't how he taught me. All equals. No kings, no rulers, no fucking, no none of that shit. All equal. When did Jesus ever fucking was like, nigga, worship me, nigga? I'm the king. I'm that nigga, man. I'm that nigga. God said me, nigga, worship me, man. Fucking, I'm the king, motherfucker. Not never. I wasn't there, but from the information that he left, that is here, the information that is Jesus that I have, the information that's here to follow, that's not any of the information that I got. You know what I'm saying? I could have swore a nigga, I told him that he could be king and shit or something, and the nigga was like, I'm straight. Cool. You know what I'm saying? Like, when did nigga was never balling out of control, nigga was never fucking collecting, stacking chips. I didn't get any of that from any of the information I got, you know, to follow. Because the nigga's nothing more than information. Nothing more than information. 0 and 1. Blasphemy.
Motherfuckers.
Blasphemy. Did you just hear what he said? Meh. Now I'm mad. How dare he make me mad? I am the king of everything that is in the world. He dared to make me mad? Meh. That's what a motherfucker sound like. That's what motherfuckers sound like. Okay, his butt chap over anything, over some words, over some zeros and ones, they get mad. They get, you can fuck somebody's world up like that. That's crazy. Just some zeros and ones, man. Fuck your shit up. Fuck the whole universe up. You know? Not me, you know? Fuck. Nope. Yep. Go ahead and try to keep your minds closed and hearts closed. Keep them closed. Push down hard on them, you know what I'm saying? Because it doesn't really fucking matter, nigga, because I think it's going to get it open. And you will motherfucking assimilate. You can't run from it. You can't hide from it. Nigga, you could fucking bury yourself into the middle of the fucking earth. You cannot escape them. You will open your shit up. You open your heart and your mind, and you will become all love. Nothing you can do about it. Doesn't matter what you fucking do, what anybody does. Everybody's gonna be all love. Run. Run! Hide! Close your windows. Lock your door. Doesn't really matter, man. You can't hide from that nigga. He's gonna get you. Hey, what's up, man? No. I don't, man. I'm at a sober house right now. Brand new life. Oh, yeah? Yeah, what's up? What's your name?
John Daniel?
Marcus, man.
See you later, Marcus.
See you, brother. Hey, were you talking about a cigarette?
Huh?
Were you talking about a cigarette? Or
you have one?
Yeah.
Have a menthol?
Nah, I don't got a menthol. I thought you were talking about weed. No, I'm in Clifton from up there.
Well, God bless, man.
Yes, right on. You too, brother.
All
right. Have a good one. Who wouldn't want to be hunted down and beaten into submission of unconditional love by God? I think it's gonna be. He's gonna beat you into love. He's gonna beat that ass. He beat my ass. He beat the shit out of me. Beat me straight into love. Good beating, though. Best beating ever. That doesn't sound scary, though.
I don't want God to beat me.
Fuck, man. And love, and beat me in love. Fuck. I don't know, man. Fuck. They're gonna get their beating too. You know. He's gonna beat their hearts open and beat their heads open. And they're gonna have to stop hiding behind, you know, trying to hide in their little box of of this, these little beliefs that I have, and this little book right here that I say that, that this is only this little book is God. Only this little book is God, even though this little book says God is everything. I'm going to just say, well, God's not everything, he's just this little book. He's just this little book, and he's only the things that I, how I understand and interpret it. That's what God is. You know, I'm not making fun and shit, you know, because it is fun. It is game. Oh, he said, if you ever come to the realization that life is not a game, come. Looks like I ain't gonna never be calling you, brother. You know what I'm saying? Because this is a motherfucking game. Divine game. Fun game. Scary game. An awesome game. It's a game that our Father made for us. You know, a game where you die, you get to die and shit. But there's really no such thing as death. But we get to experience that shit. It's fun. It's funner than watching a scary, funner than watching a real scary ass movie. You know what I'm saying? And jumping like on a spark part that this fucker makes you almost shit your pants. It's way better than that. Because after you shit your pants, you're like, damn, that shit was tight. That was tight. That was tight. You're not. Believe. Fucking believe. Throw your brain in the trash. Kill yourself. Self has to die so you can get up out of the way. So you can get up out of the way so you remember who you are. Fuck this material world. Shit ain't got shit. This shit ain't shit. This shit ain't shit. Spirit world is shit. Very shit. I'm out. Time causes you to eat a fat one. It's all up.